On August 31, 1955, William Cobb of General Motors demonstrates world's first 15-inch fully solar-powered car named Sunmobile. But even after 68 years, no solar-powered car is commercially available yet. When the billionaire Elon Musk is the owner of both electric and solar companies, that is Tesla and SolarCity, then why is he simply not making solar-powered electric vehicles? Well, the answer to this question is not that simple. In this episode of Veracity, we'll try to answer about why multi-billion dollar cars and tech companies failed to create a commercially available fully solar powered car. So without further ado, let's get started. We know that the sun is an abundant source of energy. The sun is continuously transferring energy of about 1.36 kilowatts or 1360 watts per square meter per hour. This means that 173 trillion kilowatts of power hit the earth every hour. This amount of power is so close to the total energy consumption of the world for 1 year, which is around 190 trillion kilowatt hours. So a little more than 1 hour of energy from sun is enough to power the entire earth over 1 year. This demonstrates the tremendous potential of solar energy. To examine the use of solar power for cars, we considered a Tesla Model 3 as an example. Tesla Model 3 is about 4.7 meters long and 1.85 meters wide, so its total area is about 8.7 meters square. If we cover the entire roof of the car with solar panels, we could generate about 12 kilowatts of constant power or 16 horsepower in a perfect world. This would enable the car to travel at a constant speed of about 100 kilometers or 62 miles per hour as long as the sun is shining, which is quite impressive. And if we charge the car batteries using the solar panels, the car can also be driven at night. The long range of Tesla Model 3 car has a battery capacity of 75 kilowatt hour. Through solar panels, this battery could be charged in 6 hours and 15 minutes, which is enough to provide driving range of about 550 to 600 kilometers in real world. So if everything is fine, then why don't we simply attach solar panels and batteries to the car? Well, here's a twist. These all estimates are for an ideal world scenario under perfect stable conditions. But in real world, the numbers are far away from it. Before we can fully harness solar energy, we must account for various factors. Firstly, not all solar energy that enters our atmosphere reaches the Earth's surface, as around 22% is reflected by the atmosphere and clouds, and 23% is absorbed by the atmosphere. Therefore, only approximately 55% of solar energy that entered the atmosphere is actually usable. So we have only got 55% of 1.36 kilowatt hours to actually use. Secondly, even with solar panels, there are theoretical limits to their efficiency. For instance, a single layer solar panel's theoretical limit is around 33% efficient, which is commonly found in our homes. However, this efficiency increases to 68.7% with infinite layers under normal sunlight and up to 86.8% if the sunlight is concentrated with infinite layers. In case of car, we can only use a single layer solar panel, which means our maximum efficiency is 33.7%. Thirdly, since the Earth's surface is curved, solar panels will not always receive direct sunlight, which affects their efficiency, and this curvature is unfortunate for solar because if you think about a car that is perpendicular to sun rays, it's getting a lot of solar energy. But if the car is driving away from sun, it's not gonna get a lot of energy. So we have to take consideration of total area of the Earth's surface and an average of that. So if you are just looking at the cross section of the Earth, then it's pi r square. But you are actually looking at the hemisphere of Earth. Having sunlight hit on it, then it's 2 pi r square. So instead of just 1360 watt per square meter, you actually just have 680 watts on average per square meter. And on the other side of the Earth, you don't have any sunlight, then you take the total average of the Earth's surface area and consider how much energy you have hitting it at any given moment, the average over 24 hours on the surface of the Earth is going to be about 340 watts per square meter. Concluding it, there are three main factors to consider when calculating the amount of solar energy that we can use. Summing up it, the total amount of solar energy that enters our atmosphere, the percentage of that energy that makes it to the Earth's surface, and the efficiency of solar panels. By taking all these factors into account, we can calculate that a flat Earth would provide around 250 actual watts of energy for our purpose. Assuming we use an accurate model of the Earth, the amount of power received from the Sun would be reduced to half, to 125 watts. In a 24 hours period, the average amount of power received per square meter in a specific location would be approximately 63 watts. If we apply more realistic numbers to a Tesla covered in solar panels, assuming 80% of its 8.7 square meter surface is covered as windshield and side windows must be excluded from covering, 85% charging efficiency and ideal sunlight, the power going into the battery pack would be 1.5 kilowatts with an actual average power of 0.375 kilowatts over 24 hour cycle. Therefore, the driving speed we could maintain indefinitely would be about 19 km per hour or 12 miles per hour. Using the average total power of 63 watts, it would take approximately 200 hours or 8.3 days to fully charge the car's battery pack, making it impractical for regular use. While these numbers are slightly better than expected, they still illustrate why solar-powered cars are not practical yet. Due to the cost and limited values of solar panels on the vehicles of this size, that requires a significant amount of energy to move. A car made by Aptera Motors, which is not yet available in the market but is planned to be produced soon, its specifications are quite impressive as it claims to get all of its energy from the sun, meaning that it never needs to be charged depending on how much you drive. The car offers a range of about 250 to 1000 miles depending on the battery pack you choose. And it can accelerate from 0 to 60 miles per hour in just 3.5 seconds with a top speed of over 100 miles per hour. The drag coefficient of this car is only 0.13, which is a key factor in making solar power work. The heaviest version of car with a 1000-mile range and a 100 kWh battery pack weighs about 2200 pounds, which is similar to the weight of a Mazda Miata. Safety is a concern with small cars like this, but the Aptera car has a decent weight to it, which makes it relatively safe. The car's solar panels cover 3 square meters and generate up to 700 watts of power. Its driving efficiency is about 100 watt hours per mile, which is 2 to 3 times more efficient than a Tesla Model 3. The car's solar panels are good enough to provide 40 miles of range each day, which means they can charge the battery with 4000 watt hours of energy each day. This translates to driving over 14,000 miles in a year for free, assuming an 89% charging efficiency for the battery. While having the large surface area is usually essential to generate enough power from solar panels, this car's low energy consumption and decent surface area make it theoretically possible to have a solar-powered car. Overall, the Aptera car's impressive specifications and ability to run on solar power make it an exciting prospect in an automotive industry. While solar-powered cars may not be practical for everyday use, they do have some potential applications. For example, they could be used for a short trip or in remote areas where charging infrastructure is not available. Ultimately, the key to transitioning to renewable energy in transportation may be a combination of technologies including electric cars, hybrids, and fuel cells. Solar power may play a role in this transition, but it's not likely to be the sole solution. Maybe through future technology, it may be possible to drive a fully eco-friendly solar-powered car. Thanks for watching the video. Like if you like the video, subscribe the channel, and I will see you guys in the next one. Peace out.